Well, if that wasn't enough of a prize for you, then how would you like the chance to take home £5,000 and take part in a glamorous photo shoot in Ibiza? The only downside is that you you have to be willing to show off your boobs.
Yes. The Sun's newspaper infamous Bust in Britain competition is back, but in the year of 2019, is this kind of contest still welcome or is it an outdated idea?
Two people who have very strong opinions on this, former Page Three girls Melinda Messenger and Nicola McLean, both, despite obviously modelling for the newspaper in the past, they've got these very different views on the subject. Welcome to both of you.
Welcome.
Melinda, you think
both.
It's outdated?
I do. I mean, I do feel that it's just a bit old-fashioned, and we have evolved and moved on so much, particularly in the last few years. We've had the Me Too movement, which is all about not sexualising women, not objectifying women, being conscious of the imagery that we're putting out there and the message that we're sending to kids. It's all about that. And then we have something like this, which is basically a competition where women are going to be judged against each other on who has the best boobs. I mean, if that doesn't epitomise objectification and sexualisation, I don't know what does.
Do you regret being a pastry girl?
I don't regret it at all, but, you know, I'm 2 years off 50 now. Would I do it now? Absolutely not. If I guess if I knew what I knew now, I probably wouldn't do it. I mean, for me, everybody has different reasons, and I can only speak for myself. But I think, for me, there was probably something about getting a validation through doing that kind of
right.
thing and feeling good enough, whereas perhaps if I'd had a stronger sense of myself and my own sense of self-esteem, I wouldn't have felt the need to do it. Yes. So that's all I'm saying. That was my story. That's not necessarily everybody else's.
Well, no. I mean, Nicola, you say yours was a very different experience from that. And you believe that as long as women want to take part in these contests, then why can't they?
Yeah, I think that's why I feel so strongly about it, because I agree with most of what you said. But when we've fought so hard for women to be able to have choice and be able to do what we want to do without judgment, but now we're saying this is outdated. But 1,000 women entered this last year. 1,000 women didn't think it was outdated. 1,000 women wanted to do this. So why is it up to us to take away their choice? Also, the girl that won it last year, Lulu Cole, she was 22. She'd had, I hope I say this right, she was born with asymmetry when one of the boobs is like much bigger than the other, went through all her, you know, teenage years feeling so self-conscious about it, blah, blah, blah. She felt like she wanted to enter this, to have a glamorous photo shoot. She did it. She won £5,000. She spent the money on her mum's chemotherapy. Like, I just feel like it's not what people think. It's people's choice. I absolutely loved it. And I hate to hear Melinda say that she wouldn't have done it, because Melinda was one of my idols. Like, I absolutely had the best time, and I would never have got to where
What about the events now, whether it's the boxing events or Formula One, where you had the women who walked around and they loved the day out, loved the job, you know, part of a career, earning money, and now they think, right, OK, well, you can't do that anymore because that's wrong for women.
You know, when Page Three went, I came on most shows talking about the fact that I thought it was ridiculous that women have taken away one of our jobs as a woman if we want to do it. And I had all the Page Three girls messaging me saying, thank you so much. Like, they were out of a job and people have enjoyed it. I wasn't a pit girl, I wasn't a boxing girl, but I would have done that job and I wouldn't have felt objectified because
Melinda,
it was my choice.
I did feel that, yeah, in retrospect I did, absolutely. You know, of course I was there as an ornament. I literally had no other purpose than to drape myself on front of a car, you know, and so-called sort of look pretty. So there wasn't a male equivalent there, and if there had been, then perhaps there would be this sort of sense of equality. And I totally get what you're saying. It's not the girls aren't wrong, but we've been conditioned. We've been conditioned into a way of thinking,
I totally disagree.
When you see people campaigning to stop this competition or other things, and women campaigning about this...
Yeah, it really, really bothers me.
Right.
I feel so strongly that, you know, if women are being forced to do something, you guys know me, I'm going to be here saying that's absolutely 100% wrong. But it's a choice. They're entering a competition. It's a choice. They are making that choice. It's not even like they've just been called up by their agent. pregnant and given a job and they're like, oh, I've got to take it. They are making this choice.
But what's the message for younger girls, though? If they watch this if they see this in the newspaper, you can only do this, obviously, if you've got the right sort of boobs. And you can't do this if you haven't got... If you're flat-chested, you can't come.
I disagree, because, I mean, it stopped when Melinda decided to give up page three, that no longer implants were allowed on page three. That all was Melinda's message, because they were so gutted that she decided not to
but
do
Melinda,
it. That
but, well,
I only did it for 3 months, 22 years ago. I think they ended it back in 2012. But for this reason, because what we've got to... I understand what you're saying. Absolute freedom of choice to follow the career path you want. But what's really important is the responsibility we have for the messages
we have
out there for our young
We have social media now. We have much more pressure on young people. More young people are killing themselves now.
Absolutely.
They don't feel they have the perfect body or the perfect lives.
But that's coming from Instagram.
If they look
not...
at something, look at something like that, would do you think it would affect them?
I do absolutely think it would affect them. I know my daughter would and my sons would cringe and feel so uncomfortable if they saw that. You know, and it's not
a picture of someone in their bra.
No, so a competition where women are being judged based on their boobs. And this is because it's a different time we're in. And it's not a reflection on the women. It's not a judgment on the women. What it's saying is, what is the underlying message that we are putting out to our kids about how they should be seen? There are hundreds and thousands of girls that don't want to be sexualised or be viewed in that way.
Is there a male equivalent of this? I'm just saying, Lauren says, I'm sure women are smart enough to make their own decisions about about their own bodies. Would people be complaining if it was topless men showing their six-packs?
Well, no, and, you know, whenever the big sportsmen and people do advertising campaigns in tiny briefs, we're not on here saying, let's stop that.
It's not
that.
A level playing field.
How?
Though,
that, because that women, I will. How? Because why is it not? If I've got.
It was only 100 years ago that we got the vote.
Yeah.
In 1950s, you know, women didn't have the rights to go out and work. You know, it's taken us
but
a
we
long
have
time
now.
To get.
We have now. So what's the difference in me? I was on page three of The Star on Sunday. The first time I appeared was 20 years ago, so they did like a thing. So what's the difference of me in a bikini on page three or putting David Beckham in his pants on page three? There is no difference. If you feel like there's a difference, we haven't moved as further. I don't feel like there is.
Because it's not a level playing field. The whole Me Too movement is about this. It's about the fact that women still get paid less than men. It's about that they still are objectified. It's that they're looked at in a sexual way. My 15-year-old daughter, you know, that she is judging her own body through the eyes in which we look at women.
That's because of Instagram. That's not because of this.
We have to leave that there, though. The Sun say, we won't presume any women's motives for entering, so we'll let some of our entrants from previous years competitions comment for themselves. One said, it doesn't matter what size and shape you are, it's empowering. Another said, after having my daughter 19 months ago, my body confidence had a knock. You boosted it by putting my picture in the Sun. Another said, the competition is all about celebrating confidence. It's great to see real women who haven't been filtered or photoshopped in the paper.
Thank you both very much.
Thank you very much indeed.